notochords occur throughout life and all through the length of the body. In first of all, let's understand that we have classified the phylums into in animals into invertebrata and vertebrata. Now, this was on the basis of the presence of internal skeleton. This was on the basis of internal skeleton, whether this is present or not. Okay. So, invertebrata, they do not have. Invertebrata, they do have. Okay. So, now next, let's talk about it, that in invertebrata, as we move along the phylums, as we move, do you know that as we move along the phylums, their complexity increases as we move from porifera, as you move from porifera to echinodermata, or for that matter, more than that, cephalochordata, we can say, or for that matter, we move to cephalochordata, we will say that their complexity is increasing. Okay, now let's talk about them. That as their complexity increases, they also develop a certain sort of solid structure that gives support to their body. Okay, so here we are talking about that this notochord is what that develops into vertebrata, that develops into vertebral column in vertebrates. So you can call it a pre-vertebral column, primitive version that is going to evolve into a vertebral column. Okay, now this notochord is, if we were to talk about its structure, so it is mesodermally derived from the germ layer, which is mesoderm. Okay, and let's talk about that this is a solid rod of turgid cells which is present in the caudate. Okay, now let's see that this notochords are persistent throughout life and all through the length of the body. So for example, this is a body of organism. So notochord is present all throughout the life, and this is present all through the body in this organism. And this is the notochord. This is present in the phylum, which is cephalochordata. This is present in the phylum cephalochordata, and hence the correct answer is option A.